sitting here. I thoroughly enjoyed the session. It's been great listening to everyone. In just a bit, we'll show you what it's doing. It's actually telling you how much am I enjoying doing what I'm doing right here. Right? It's telling you something about what's going on in my brain. Now, I wish I could put it on all of your heads and measure it, but let me start by just showing you how I'm feeling today. Right? Now, in the morning, Anurag said that, you know, he saw me sitting and, like, you know, working on the presentation. Well, actually, what I was doing was editing it, because, you know, your time is valuable, you know, your attention is short, and I'm using these general references of what we know about people. So I'm going to make sure that I try and make it as interactive as possible, right? And the best way to learn is experience. So I'm very grateful to some, you know, individuals in the audience who have are participating with us. We will give you a cue when that will start. But since everyone here should actually participate, I have just one thing that I'm going to ask you to do before I start. If I were to throw something at you, whichever hand you would catch it with, can you just raise that hand? Okay, so are some people okay being hit by what I threw at you? Because some didn't raise their hand. Okay, can we try this again? If I throw something at you, which hand will you use to catch it? That's a good question. You'll get your chance. Okay, so my topic today is the role of emotions in marketing. And honestly, you know, Google Baba will tell you more than I'm ever going to be able to tell you. So, you know, let me show you what my agenda therefore is. It's actually fairly straightforward. This is what I was doing. You know, I was just trying to figure out how can I learn when I come here, because teaching is not really my profession, right? We are practitioners, we do things, we learn, and I'm here to learn through this interaction. So my presentation is going to have three questions, in which the exercise you just did, you are going to do again, maybe a few times, right? So three questions. I'll give you the options as well, because, you know, I don't like open-ended questions. And that's the reason why you'll get options. You just need to raise your hand and, you know, and I'll do a quick sort of judgment call on which option is the winner in the hall, right? So there are three questions I'm going to use. One engagement exercise, which the, you know, the tables that have willingly participated on request to participate will do. So you'll see what we're doing at that time. And we'll show you one AV. Since we are here, you know, and my team's worked day in and day out to put this AV together, it's sort of, they told me it'll do a better job than you're doing. So I said, sure, let's put an AV up. And here comes question number one. Is everyone ready? It's not fastest finger first, it's actually, and also one key caveat is that it's going to start putting a little bit of load till you reach question number three on thinking. Okay, so the first one is very simple. You can treat it as a warm-up, but be honest to yourself. In this case, you can raise even the hand that you won't catch something with, right? That's the liberty I'm ready to give you. Okay, now, first question, right? How do we define our prospects, our target segments, the people that we want to really go after? Okay, now, if I ask you this question and leave it open-ended, we'll take half a day, right? And I can see I've got 27 minutes. I'm quite greedy. I'm going to reduce that. Okay, so here are the three options. Option one is that we define it with all the demographics, all the behavioral possibilities available to us. Option two is we make a pen portrait of that person, right? So we're not interested in the face. We've understood many things about him, you know, his psychology, you know, user behavior. So we've tried to write some things about a little bit more to flesh him out. And the consumer number three, who's making faces at us, is telling you whatever it's telling you, right? Now, how many in this audience, given an option, would define the target prospect with A only? I hope everybody's hand is perfectly intact. There's one gentleman there. Two gentlemen here. Okay. How many would define it with B? There's one gentleman there. How many would define it with C? Okay, there's quite a few, and many people who are right now Thakurs. Right? Or maybe the answer somewhere in between. Right? Let me assume that it's a hybrid of a few of these things. You know, so maybe that's the reason why, or you're really tired. Okay, you can see my engagement there. I can't see yours, so you've got an upside. Okay. Now I told you question number 2 and question number 3 will be slightly more difficult than question number 1. Okay, so I maybe live up to it, maybe I won't. You guys will surprise me. Question number 2. Which of these is the most important to you as a marketing person? There are no right or wrong answers. Okay, I don't know anybody's names here. Even if I know, I've forgotten them. Because this thing has wiped my brain clean. Right? Or is doing it as you see. A, they, which is the prospects or your target segments, buy or do not buy my brand. Right? You define it basis their purchasing behavior. B, is they recommend or do not recommend the brand. There's a reason why I've separated them out. So how many in favor of, should I reverse the flow to remove rotation bias? Maybe you get tired by the time we reach C. So how many would say that that is the most important thing, what they feel about my brand? See, so many people who have lost their hands. It's really unfortunate, but it's good, our minds are working. B, how many believe that recommendation or non-recommendation should be the basis, is the most important thing for us? Okay? And how many believe that purchasing or not purchasing my brand is the most important thing to me? Right. So my question was most important. Don't we trade off? Sorry, the phone's ringing. My colleague is a very popular person. So that's why you can see the phone ring there. Okay, now question number 3. You're right. They're very interestingly interlinked, but there's a reason why we're trying to, you know, sort of distinctly try and understand what we really seek. If you could affect only one of these, okay? If you could affect only one of these, then which one will it be? Here come your options. What they buy or do not buy, what they recommend or do not recommend, or what they feel. How many in favor of B? B? Recommendation? Yes? So if you could affect only one of these, you would affect recommendation. All right. A, buying, not buying. All right. And C, what they feel. Thank you. Many more hands up. I'm very happy. Hope my dial shows that I was. Or it probably takes a little bit of time because of Bluetooth connectivity to refresh. But you'll see that very soon. Now is the time for us to, you know, sort of do this small engagement exercise. We've got one laptop placed on this table. I think these are all my friends from MX Player, if I'm right. So thank you very much. I think Deepak's already plugged you in. There's one table with the beautiful ladies and one handsome gentleman on that table. There's one in the center table in the third row. There's one who's got a very funnier gadget than mine on. So that's the one that's also plugged in. So we've got four tables where we'll tell you what we've done. we've set up a project in our on our cloud, you know, for them to simply watch three commercials. And while they watch the commercial, I have an option to show you the commercial, but let me save it to show you along with the result. Now, all the people who are participating, please do not worry. Your individual names, numbers, digital retargeting data is not going to be presented to anyone, right? So please enjoy it as you will. Try to be as natural as possible. Obviously, this is not the best setting to do this. But there are, you know, when you see what you see after they take this, you know, engagement phase, I'm hopeful I'll have to speak lesser and my team will feel it was worth our time. So are we good to roll? It's going to take about a minute and a half, maybe. Most of the commercials are like 30 seconders. So while they focus, can I, do you have the commercials? You just have the AV? So we could have shown you the commercial so that the others are equally engaged without us knowing how they feel. So bear with me. I can maybe take this opportunity to invite any questions if there are any, just so that I don't have people falling off to sleep or my monitor going off. So are there any questions? I have not told you anything. You just told me everything. So logically, I played very safe. Yes, please.
Sir, the gadget you are wearing, it defines attention, activation, engagement, and enjoyability.
Right.
How about when your spouse is talking with you and she's wearing, she just made you wear this thing and you are on a monitor?
Okay, that's a very dangerous question, and I know it's streaming on YouTube. You're going to land me in a lot of trouble, but let me generalize. Okay, this is not pertaining to just me. Okay, I'm saying that again. It does not pertain only to me. It may pertain to many other people. Maybe, maybe not me. Now I will answer your question. Okay. Your wife can read your mind. She reads your mind from your face.
Okay.
And the same probably applies to us if we can read our spouse's mind from their face. So currently what they're doing is pretty much the same, right? What they're doing right now is we are reading their face and therefore imputing what's happening to them. However, what we're using right now is two technologies at the same time. We're using eye tracking, what they're looking at, and we're using expression analytics because they've got headphones on, I can tell you. You know, so their expressions will tell me how they felt when they watched what is put in front of them, right? And the minute they finish, I will bring the results up because it's almost sort of real time. Like you can see, my dial is probably spinning there, so I'm sending data to my cloud and getting computed. There's a lot more things you'll know about me, but I don't want to show you, you know, like my stress levels, etc. My chairman is sitting here, not a very good idea to do. So if we are done, are we done? Okay, one is done. Deepak, you'll just check what status it is there. Any other questions? Please don't ask personal questions. Don't land me in trouble. Any other questions? I can't think I can give anybody an opportunity to ask me questions. That's how I've written the presentation. Right? Some bit of our experience in writing presentations stands us good in such times. Deepak, you'll just check with the other consoles if they're done.
So two things, is it being used anywhere in the world, one. Second, what kind of a sample size are you looking at to give an indicative figure to, whatever, I mean. for a brand to take out before a launch of a content or whatever?
Sure, sure. So on the first question, you know, EEG mapping goes back decades. You know, there are, at last search, there were about 53 million articles about, you know, emotion measurement and what it really translates to into marketing action. But a search engine only delivers when you search, right? So my intention is to give you a keyword to search so that you discover a lot more that you can do, you know, because we are humans. A lot of what we do, you know, is measured through devices like this. Obviously, like mobile phones are getting smaller and smarter, the apparatus measuring EEG is getting smaller and smarter. A very big mounted one which you use in the hospital obviously goes much, much deeper to read many other things, which we don't need, right? So that's the reason why what I have on my forehead is good enough. As you can see, I can walk, I can talk, I'm not getting any electric shock. That just naturally rung, was not meant to be poetic. So it's something that gives you a lot of user, you know, and use occasions, right? So if you want somebody walking into a retail shop, you want to know how the person's feeling, the person straps it on his head, walks in, gives you a great understanding of experience. The expression analytics, once you see the results, you know, you're running a retail shop, there's a salesperson, there are mirrors in public areas, the person goes, you know, checks things out. The person's expression tells you whether the person liked something or not, right? It's all about us being able to, we always say, customize to a universe of one. So it's very important for some use cases to not ignore what each person has to say. Right? So a BMW buyer, how many of them are there? There might be a few in this room, but it's not a very large market, right? So depending upon where you're using it, you'll have to decide whether you need a sample. If you're using it for testing and, you know, ensuring that your conclusions are, you know, representative of a population, then you have to ask the question of sample. If you are very concerned about customers who are walking into a Vodafone store, right, and sitting there, we're picking up a lot of information. I can today use your CCTV, which is sitting there, plug it into my backend and tell you what the mood of your customers is, right? Everyone tries to reduce wait time, but what you can't control is the population. So maybe there are different things you can do to keep their stress level low. And when they go to the desk, you know, very easily with a standard camera, I can tell you what were they feeling. So the store manager there can get up and go to the port where there is the most aggrieved customer, right? So again, that's the power of focusing on an individual.
Technology currently available in India? One, for instance, if I'm trying to make content and I come to you, so this will go as a MarTech solution, right?
Right.
Marketing technology solution. So I say that I'm trying to launch this kind of content. Can you, Pradeep, tell me what kind of, you know, consumer should I go to, creating a sample size, and then I come, you come back to me and then I create that content. Is it possible?
Yes. So we can, we are already in conversation with a few and we can do that with many more. Currently what we're doing is, you know, we're operating like a SaaS model, so we're helping people to make sense of it and also giving them recommendations so that they deploy it. Eventually, you know, you can have an enterprise solution, upload your stuff, you know, we've done a back-to-back integration with, you know, global panels. So you select the profile, the invitation goes out, you get the results back. Right, so we've done that already. We haven't put a payment gateway right now, but we will at some time. In addition to that, there are further, you know, use cases. So for instance, if you have a app, right, and you want to know what does a person feel when he's using your app, right? What he does, you know. How he feels is what we want to tell you. And that's why I asked you the question earlier. Is his behavior or his outcome of his behavior critical to you, or how he feels about you? If he feels very nice and good about you, there's good evidence for you to see a good service provider has been able to keep customers, you know, and then is able to cater to their taste. The use cases are several. You know, deployment is not a challenge whatsoever. For me, the question that always comes to our mind when we take such solutions out is, how will you really plug it into your business, right? So if you have a, you're an OTT player and your user gives you permission, then, you know, I can tell you what any selected set that you want tested randomly is feeling about your content, because face analytics is very easy for me to do with the mobile phone cam.
And it's dynamic on the fly.
It's real time.
It's real.
That's my brainwave. And you'll see if they've finished their project, we'll just show you the result. I think one of them is still enjoying. Sorry? That one is also done. They were not done? Not working, okay. And this is not because of our cloud, this is because of the connectivity in the hotel. Just to make it absolutely clear. Any other questions you'll have, you know, be more than glad to take them. I've got 10 minutes, but I've got nothing much more than like a 2-3 minute AV to show you with prettier faces and better music and good graphics. And then I'm pretty much done. Yes, please.
Privacy.
Sorry?
Privacy of the user.
Privacy of the user.
Yeah.
Very good question. So, you know, there's a development we're doing right now. Obviously, you seek the permission of the user. You're not looking at the user without the user permitting you to do it.
Just to interrupt you there. Basically, if I give a
Do you want to take the mic?
Sure. If I take the permission, right,
yes,
of a user.
Yes.
When you take, for example, if you take a permission on a Facebook app, you
yeah.
tell, I need, I'm okay to share my email, I'm okay to share my contact list of friends maybe.
Right.
But in your case, you will just say a permission is, I will be able to record you. But exactly what all you will be recording, that's that permission is not possible, right, one by one?
Of course it's possible.
Okay.
We are GDPR compliant today. We are deployed in Turkey in Vodafone. You know, they are rolling it out across multiple offices. In Europe, GDPR has already put a footprint, so we are GDPR compliant. So we have the, it's very easy for us to go and ask a customer. The bigger question as a researcher I can tell you is, why will a customer say yes, right? For that, we are adding a gamification layer to the facial detection, you know, or the expression analytics. So it becomes fun for the person to see how the person felt, and then the person can socially share. Right? Those are options that we can provide to the user. So if you tell somebody, hey, you know, check this out, we'll tell you whether you liked it or not. Would you be interested? For that, you need to give me these permissions. And he can see that we're not looking at his face. The analytics is not done by actually recording a video of yours and somebody sitting in the back end and, you know, telling you were they happy, were they sad, you know, filling that out. It's not done based on that. Sorry, there's Pulak's got another call. Right, so it's not done, you know, with anybody sitting there. There's a, you know, engine sitting which computes and it tracks the key points on your face that tell you what expression the person is making. And this product has been developed for the global market. So from a Mongolian to a Chinese to a Japanese to a Korean, the AI has been adjusted to give you, you know, emotions accordingly. So expanses of our country anywhere are not a problem. Yes. Are we done with the tests? How many have you finished? That is also done. This is also done. Yeah. Not done. So you got only. Okay. Yeah, sure. You'll. Okay, okay. All right, so I'm sorry, will you, can I take this question, Pulak? Yeah, I'll just take this question and then we'll go to it. Yes.
So my question is this available for app developers now to use on their own app and provide it as a solution, use it as a solution on the app itself?
Yes, it is.
It is.
Yes, it is. Obviously, what we need to do is, you know, get the user permission. And whether you want to do it, now, what do you really want to do about the app is the question. If you want to know how the person feels and there are certain developmental work that you want to do on the app, then we need to use this, okay, which I am wearing.
Okay.
Right? If you are showing them content, or you're showing, you know, you want
if I want just an
emotional read, then we can, you know, work on the fly and do a deep integration in your app.
So if I want to track the engagement of the user on my app, what
that's
are the
very,
level of engagement?
That can be done on the fly across the board.
Okay, all right, thank you.
Yes. Can we show you the results quickly and, you know, and please allow me to show you the AV. And then I'll continue taking questions. We've got 5 minutes. I think that should be sufficient. Pulak, you put the... Okay, we've not had a very successful, you know, experiment here because only one respondent, as in one table, was able to submit results. So again, it's not representative, but it's demonstrative. And that was the idea. The idea is to essentially show you, you know, if I use eye tracking, and it was just done, you know, on that table for the ad called Polycab Green. The second ad was, Pulak, stay with me. Thank you. Saregama Caravan, the Diwali ad. And then the maneuver after 1 year marriage, you know, exchange between Virat and Anushka. So now, if you can show just the eye tracking for one, or two or three, whatever you want to do, and then we'll go to the expression analytics. So the expression analytics gives you the emotions that were expressed.
मैं हमेशा ख्याल रखूंगा.
मैं भी.
क्यों कर रहा शादी?
देख, सोच ले. महीने में 15 दिन खाना मैं बनाऊंगा बोलेगा, लेकिन जब उसकी बारी आएगी, होम डिलीवरी ऑर्डर करेगा.
टीवी रिमोट, एसी रिमोट, लाइट का रिमोट, सब हाथ से चला.
अरे इधर टावल, उधर जूते, सुबह 5 बजे पर्दे खोल देगा और किलर पेट्टी बनाकर पिलाएगा.
कैरम में हारने पर रोएगी पीटेगी, पर ना क्यूट लगेगी.
और हमेशा ख्याल रखेगा.
हमेशा. अरे इतना सोच मत.
बहुत सोचते हो यार.
मान्यवर मोहित, नए रिश्ते नए वादे हमेशा.
इस दिवाली आप अपनों के लिए क्या ले जाएंगे? शोर या संगीत? 5000 पुराने गानों का एक नया तोहफा, सारेगामा कारवां.
अगले महीने मेरा बिजली का बिल कम आएगा. लगी शर्म.
लगी.
पार्टी चल रही है.
नहीं, मातम मना रहा हूं.
तुम्हारा बिल मेरे बिल से कम कैसे?
कब से कह रहा हूं कि पॉली के वायर लगाओ, बिजली बचाओ.
पॉली क्या? कनेक्शन बचत का, कनेक्शन जिंदगी का.
So this is the kind of heat map that you'll typically see on an ad or any content that you create. So if you have a print ad, you know, you'll put it in front of a consumer, you can see what the person's doing. You can use it also for website tests. So you have a website navigation, you know, you can figure out how they're moving around. This is like the really basic thing to do. And we'll just show you how the expressions get captured. So So do you all want to take a pick at which one do you want to see? So we can go straight to that. I think, you know, in the interest of time, I've got 1 minute left and maybe there's a question. Do you all want to choose? You want to show the options? The engagement ad, Saregama ad, Go Green ad. Saregama ad, okay, let's go for Saregama.
इस दिवाली आप अपनों के लिए क्या ले जाएंगे, शोर या संगीत? 5000 पुराने गानों का एक नया तोहफा, सारेगामा कारवा।
So you can see how the emotions moved. The part where, you know, he was petting that cute little fellow was this part, and you can see a very distinct peak of happiness coming through. Engagement would essentially be any movement in emotions, right? And then there are, of course, other measures that come through as well. Can I proceed and please play the AV? Otherwise, my team's going to kill me because they worked through the night for it. Can you play the AV, please? Thank you.
The world of market research and consumer insights is tricky. Don't trust mere words, for words may lie, but emotions don't. Go, conquer the senses of your consumers. Step into the future of market research and consumer insights, where no questions will be framed, no answers will be sought, where emotions will be tracked and expressions will be caught. Give in to the revolution. Bow down to the master of tracking genuine emotions through artificial intelligence. Sensei. Sensei adopts a three-pronged process to create insights and fuel brand growth in all sectors. Using metrics like heat maps, eye tracking captures precisely where the subject's eyes move and what they fixate on, allowing accurate assessment of exact product viewing and scanning behavior. Using a webcam, the technology of expressions analytics helps detect micro-expressions made during the engagement. They convey non-verbal communication cues that demonstrate how a person actually feels during the engagement. The brainwave mapping tracks and records brainwave patterns to gauge emotions driven by attention, activation, engagement, and enjoyment. Be it short content like commercials, promos, or video clips, or long formats like web and TV series, your sensei will provide you with real-time actionable insights and product and packaging research, EQ for automobiles, and much, much more. Insights will no longer be biased. Research will no longer be skin deep. Sensei is here to delve deeper into the hearts, into the minds, into the psyche of your consumers, to dredge up precise, real-time, actionable insights. In this tricky world of market research, Sensei is the future, and the future is here.
Thank you. My team will be very elated. As I speak, they're watching all this on YouTube. So everybody who's put in a lot of hard work will really feel very glad it's shown this result. I will call them out in a bit. This is all done. So this was one thing that caught my attention very nicely. So I thought I must put the person who actually dropped it, you know, and which I've just put into my presentation. Well, you can read it. Either the emotions can get in the way or can get us on the way. It really depends upon how we're going to, you know, sort of get, start forming a relationship with our customers, right? And then our minds are a very powerful thing. It's very important for us to understand that we emote when we see any kind of communication, right? So on that note, Right, so here are our details. You can reach us. We also have our website up and running. It's sensilab.com is the website. So you can feel free to take a look at how it's sitting there right now. Just to give a little bit of the master bit, you know, I just don't like saying we are the best. We are always learning to get better. And when we work with you and we work on your challenges and we find opportunities, we just keep getting better and better, right? And that's how anybody learns, and so do the machines, and so does our intelligence grow. The coinage, the words that were used in the AV were because sensei in Japanese means master, right? So we are seeing it more as a tool which will help you master, you know, your emotional engagement with your customers. And that's the reason why we had a play of words. And our aim is to help you to get mastery over consumer senses, right? And that's why it's sensei. The sensei is spelled with a EI. This is spelled with a AI because we've got AI. That's pretty much it. Thank you very much. And thank you for being very patient, interactive. And I hope raising of the hand was not objectionable to anyone. And especially the tables, which really, you know, made a serious effort to help us. Very indebted. Sorry, you know, we were struggling with the Wi-Fi connectivity since morning. Afternoon, this guy has not eaten any food. And yeah, at this moment, I have to call out people who have made this possible. Other than the friends who will see this video, who I can't call out because they worked with us through the night and, you know, were consultants to us to get some of the stuff ready. There's Pulak, who's probably slept barely a night in the last 2 days, who's really contributed a lot. Rati, who's on the other side of the camera in Mumbai, she's not in good health, so she couldn't join us today. She was a marketing person. She's also, you know, helped get the Sensei logo, and since the baby was to be born, she's put in a lot of effort, so I can't do this without thanking them. Ashokji and Karan, who through their leadership and solid support have, you know, allowed us as a company, which otherwise was doing one vertical, you know, we are widening our play, and, you know, and they are strong pillars of support that they have always been in this organization. So I have to thank these gentlemen and that one lady there. Otherwise, you know, what I'm doing today won't have been possible. And of course, our technology partner, Entropic, we've not made a press release. We're going to make it tomorrow, actually on Tuesday, because Monday is election day in Maharashtra. So we will put that release out at that time. But they have worked very closely with us. We're working very, very deeply to make everything that you see even more richer, more useful, and to really give you the opportunity to master consumer emotions and really fast, right? Not wait for somebody to tell you how people have felt, but for you to see it in the real time. That's it from me. Thank you very much. If there are any questions, I'm way out of time. I don't like to bite into anybody else's time, so I'm going to call it out right now. I'm going to be here. I have a 10:30 flight to catch, so, you know, please feel free to, you know, nudge me. If we can't speak, I'll take your business card and I will certainly get back to you. Right? Thank you very much.